morning. Today is March 24th and we are down at Animal Control off of Selt Road. It's 91 Selt Road. It is a beautiful sunny day, a little bit on the chilly side, but there's some great exciting things happening here. We have some families here interested in adopting some of the babies today, and they have them out in the yard playing and seeing who wants to play ball and who would be a good member of their family. So never, ever, ever think that you cannot come down here, play with the animals, get to know them. You don't have to take them home until you get to know them and make sure that they can be a good part of your family. The last thing we want them to do is to go home with you and then end up back here because it didn't work out for some reason. Do keep in mind that if you do adopt from Animal Control, several of the trainers in town will give you at least one free training session consultation, and then sometimes we'll give you a discount going forward as well. With your adoption here down at Animal Control, $70 for the female, or for the felines, for the cats, and that includes spay and neuter, and includes their vaccines and a microchip, so that pet, if they should get lost from you, would again come back to you and not be here at Animal Control again. For the dogs, the price is $126, and again, that does include the spay and neuter, and it does include the vaccines and a heartworm test. So you'll know going in whether you're going to need to budget a little bit of money for the heartworm treatment as well. We have a lot of things going on, so I think we'll go ahead and get started with our first pet, and then stay tuned at the end because we have some exciting events coming up, and we definitely want to make sure that you and your family join in. Hey guys, we are back now with Miss Cheyenne. If you'll remember, I was here a few weeks ago and I actually named her Cheyenne because she was so shy in the cage and she just held back and wasn't sure what to do. And so I went over to the cage and she just kind of came up real sweetly and calmly. She's just so shy, but she's sweet. She loves being in your lap.
Yes, she's a good baby.
Cheyenne is a mother herself. You can tell that she has had some babies, and she definitely is ready to be a baby herself. She needs to be pampered and loved and cuddled and showered with hugs and kisses. She was a stray. She's been here since February. She's one of the smaller dogs that are here. Christina, did she walk well on a leash outside, or does she need some training on that?
Well, I've only took her out for a couple minutes.
Okay. Okay.
But she was eating grass somewhere out there.
Hey,
I
fed
and loved on her a little bit, so.
So she just needs somebody to work with her and love her and spoil her rotten. So make this her lucky month of March. Come on down and give Cheyenne a home. We'll see you soon. Hey guys, we are back with Martin. Martin is one of 26 cats here at Animal Control today. As you can tell, the numbers are a little bit lower today, but kitten season is upon us, guys. I've heard in the last week of two litters that needed to be bottle fed because the mom, something happened. She was either separated or was unable to nurse them. So don't let the low numbers, let's get it to zero. We can do that. We can do it together. So Martin is here in C5. He's about a year old. When I walked by the kennel, he immediately started batting at me, wanting to play. And so he definitely wants your attention. He wants to cuddle. He definitely wants to explore your home. So come and give him a home and let me see if I can get him to give you a good look with his beautiful face. Hey, Martin. Hey, are you a good boy? Come on down and give Martin some love. He just wants to cuddle up with you. Hi, we are back with Pippa. Pippa is a nice size at 43 pounds. She's 8 months old. She is listed as a lab mix, but if you look at her coat, she may have some ridge back in her or something. She just has that gorgeous color on her. She's quite energetic. Hey, she is heartworm negative, and she does want to be a member of your family. She is located in kennel B14, and she does like treats, as you can see. What a good girl. Not food aggressive, no. So do come on down and see Pippa and give her a little time with your family to see if it's a good mix. Pippa's been here since the end of January, and she was located off of Boy Scout Road, and she definitely needs an energetic family. So if you have some energetic children that are begging for a pet, this might be the perfect match. They can wear each other out, they can lay down and take naps together, and maybe your children need to read a story to Pippa and work on their reading skills. There's lots of things that your pet can do to help your children grow, teaching them responsibility financially and, as far as chores as well. And then also they can sit and listen to your child read, and they can definitely help each other burn some calories off. Hey, Pippa. Come on down and meet Pippa. And give her some treats and give her some love and see if she'd be a good member of your family. Hey guys, we're back with Dayton. Dayton is sweet and ready to explore. Dayton is a stray that was picked up on March 14th from Country Club Road. We are spending a little time cuddling and snuggling, but I think Dayton is missing Miss Jeanette. Jeanette is typically here filming, but she did have a prior engagement today. We just have some new people coming in, and Dayton wants to go visit, so we'll see you guys later. Hey guys, we are back with Kilo. Kilo is 45 pounds and is about a year old and really ready to romp and run. Kilo's been playing in the yard. There was another dog outside, and Kilo slipped from his leash, but he did not show any aggression to the other dog. He did not go after it, so Kilo might be really interested in playing with another pet if you have a pet in your home and just want to expand your family. Kilo probably would do very well going to the dog parks and just playing and getting some of this energy out. He has had all of his vaccines, and he is heartworm negative. So once he's neutered and microchipped, he'll be ready to go home with your family. Again, he's one of 61 dogs down here. He is available for adoption for $126, and that does include all necessary vetting. So for $126, you get this gorgeous, gorgeous color and such a great energy level. I can imagine you're coming home from work from a hard, hard day of work, and Kilo's there to meet you with some big kisses and just to hear about your day. So come on home, come on down and give him a home and give him somebody to look forward to coming home from work to. Hey guys, I'm back with Madeline. Madeline is really eager to be out of her kennel. She was scratching at us and definitely wanting out. She does have a little injury on her neck. It's nothing that won't heal. It's just a skin scrape. She was brought in on February 25th from Calico Loop. She is not a calico. She is beautiful though. I'm not sure how old she is. It doesn't say, but I would say she's a juvenile, so probably around 6 months old, maybe. Definitely not a year old. She's definitely not full grown. She could be going into heat at any time now, and so that is going to bring me into my preaching station of spay and neuter. Folks, if we all spay and neuter, then animal control wouldn't be necessary unless it's for a sick or an injured or a bite case, really what animal control should be for. Animal control should not be here to control the population for unwanted pets that are just thrown out. We just have so many pets here in the Southeast, and this one little kitten right here, over the course of 6 years, if she were allowed to have babies every time she comes into heat, and then her babies have babies, and their babies have babies, we would have about 120,000 cats in only 6 years from this one sweet baby girl. So by spaying her, we will prevent about 100,000 homeless angels. This really isn't the place for a young juvenile kitten to grow up. It really should be in a home where she can get pet and she can get food. And while she's getting food here, I don't want to imply that. But I do want to just, she needs a family and she wants someone to cuddle with and love with, and she is just purring like crazy. I wish you guys could hear that. So spay and neuter your babies. There is definitely no need not to do that. We do have financial assistance available over at the Help Spay Neuter Clinic. There's a form on our website that you can fill out that form and tell us what you can afford to pay. And you know, we search for grants and we search for funders and we help you as much as we can. We also, we find a lot of pets are turned in or abandoned due to the fact that the owners can no longer feed them. With the economy like it is, sometimes it's a choice between feeding your family or feeding your pets. And I definitely think pets should be a part of your family. But if that is an issue for you and your family, know that Newnan-Coweta Humane Society has a pet food pantry. Once a month, they distribute food on the first Saturday of the month from the Help Spay Neuter Clinic. It is a Newnan-Coweta Humane Society program, but they do distribute from the Help Spay Neuter Clinic. So if you find your family just a little bit short on pet food each month, go ahead and come down to that pet food pantry. And if you find that you have a few dollars to spare, pick up a bag of cat food or dog food and just drop it by the clinic for the pet food pantry. And we will definitely get that distributed out to families in need in this county. So back to sweet Madeline, who has been so patient through all of that and just loving this time out of her cage and exploring what's going on around her. Come on down and meet her, give her a home, get her spayed, get her a good home, get her little injury all healed up, and she'll come and be a good, happy part of your family. Hey guys, this is Digby. Digby is 38 pounds, and he is already neutered, already vaccinated, ready to come to your home today. Digby is heartworm positive. He is not interested in treats, so not food motivated, maybe toy motivated. He's been here since February 7th, and he came in from Martin Mill Road. It's possible, it seems Digby was definitely a part of a family before. He definitely loves to cuddle. He's definitely relaxing here a little bit with us. It's possible he just wandered from his family. And maybe they're out there looking for sweet Digby, and maybe Digby isn't his name. Maybe he just is waiting for us to call the right name so that he can say, oh, that's me. If your pet were to get separated from you, there's a wonderful website that would help you and the community reunite you guys. Definitely microchipping is the number one way, because then when your pet is found, we can scan the microchip, get your information, and return your pet to you. Another way that you can look for your pet, though, is findfido.com. If you go to Find Fido, they walk you through uploading a picture of your pet, a description of your pet, the location of the last known whereabouts, and it helps you print out posters of your pet and distribute them around your community. They also, I believe, I'm not positive, you guys check me on this, but I believe that they have a database of lost pets and they help reunite to the owners as well. So if your pet is gone, then you can go in there and look. But if you find a pet, you can go on Find Fido and look in your area and see if there is a pet meeting that description in your area that has been lost. Digby is just content to be with us. He spent a good bit of time out in the yard this morning. The last pet that we had on, you guys remember me saying that he got loose from his leash and played with another pet for a moment, and no aggression whatsoever from either pet. So Digby was the other pet, and I'm pretty sure I'm safe in saying there's not any aggression in Digby at all. So come on down and give Digby a chance to cuddle up by your fireplace for the next few weeks as the weather decides whether we're in spring or winter still. Or as the spring does come to us, then maybe he can go out and help you plant the flowers. Maybe he likes to dig and that's why they called him Digby. Who knows? You guys come on down and you can give him a name that you think is very fitting for him. Thank you. Hey guys, we are back with Brindle Brandy. We just discovered that this sweet angel has been here since February 28th and she was nameless. You know, she's not just a pretty face, but she's a pretty girl all over. She is about a year old. She's about 65 pounds, so she is definitely going to be one of the bigger angels in your home. She just wants to cuddle up on your sofa and give that sigh of relief of being safe and having a place to call home. She is a stray from Martin Mill Road, and she has that black collar on, and so perhaps she's another one that got loose from the owner. So find Fido.com or microchipping. You know, guys, we can get them reunited with you. We need a little help from you guys to do that. Microchipping over at the Help Spay Neuter Clinic is $25. That does include a lifetime registration. And that would give sweet Brindle Brandy here, that would give her an opportunity to get back with the family that she knows and loves and is comfortable with. If you can imagine being separated from your family and not being able to tell people who you belong with and where to take you back to, you know, it's scary. She is only a year old, and so she probably grew up with a family and she's just missing them so much. She's tugging on that leash pretty hard today, so it is kind of making her cough a little bit. She's not ill. She's just making herself
very
cough.
Energetic.
Very, very energetic. Would be one that would do wonderful with some good obedience training. We have some wonderful trainers in the area, and they could definitely help you work with her on some commands, and I imagine she would be a great, great protector of your family. So come on down and meet Brindle Brandy and take her out and run. That's what she loves. She was just running with some of the staff here, and Miss Christina saw her running and has just said she's been nothing but a gentle giant out there and just enjoyed some time out of the kennel. So they've had some exercise time this morning and she wants more. So we're gonna go ahead and let Miss Brandy go run some more. We'll talk to you in a minute. Hey guys, we are back with clearly the favorite for today, Tostito. When I say the favorite, I mean the most heartbreaking. She is absolutely shivering to pieces. She is so afraid right now. She is about a year old. She's 53 pounds and she's heartworm negative. So come and get this sweet baby. Bring her home. Give her some comfort. Let her know that she's going to be safe. She is just trembling, not knowing what's going on here. She is just afraid of the noise and the uncertainty around her. She did really well out in the yard. She did not show any aggression to other pets as they walked by. She definitely has not shown any aggression to us, but she is so afraid. She is almost paralyzed with fear. So she just needs a little extra TLC to make her feel comfortable. She will not take any treats from us today, so we're trying to do that, but she's so scared she just can't open up that door for us. She is a stray found on February 25th on Berry Avenue. She had no collar, no microchip, nothing to let us know where she belongs. So I'm sure that Tostito is not her real name and that she is missing the family and the name that truly belongs to her. Did she have any special notes that you could think of, Miss Ann? Kind of shy in her cage, or?
Yeah, she's just really shy and scared. She just needs to get out of here and get in a home, and I'm sure she'll open up in a couple weeks and be a very, very loving dog knowing that you saved her from this.
Hey, baby girl. Again, she is heartworm negative, and for $126, you get a fully vetted, sweet baby that will always be the most loyal to you because she will know that you saved her life. So come on down and give Tostito a little bit of your heart. Hey guys, I'm back with Lila. Lila will be our last kitty for today, but she is definitely one of many down here, one of 26. She is about a year old and she was She was caught on Dogwood Trail on January 2nd. So she probably was a member of a family, probably heard some fireworks on New Year's Eve and scooted on off and didn't know how to get back home. So microchip, and I imagine Find Fido could work for kitties as well. If you come down here and adopt her for $70, your name will also go in a drawing for this basket. Every cat that is adopted, the owner's name goes in a drawing, and once a month they do the drawing, and you come back down and get your basket of goodies for the angel that you chose to take home. So sweet Lila, she has been vaccinated. She just needs to be spayed, and then she could head right on home with you. She is in kennel C10, and she is just, she's letting the fur fly here a little bit. In a good way, not a bad way. She is just wanting to get down and explore a little bit. She was nuzzling up to me a little bit ago and definitely making friends with me and wondering, where is Miss Jeanette? She is usually here to take care of us kitties, right? So come on down, meet Lila. Put your name in the hat for the drawing, for the luck of the draw for the St. Patty's Day month. And we'll see who is the lucky winner that wins the most love from their adopted cat or wins the prize with the basket. Hey guys, we are back with 6-month-old energetic Bouncer. Bouncer is just doing that. Bouncing here, bouncing there. She's kind of like Tigger. She really is treat motivated, so pardon us while we grab a few more treats. She does settle in nicely with the treats. She is definitely a good, good girl. But we try to get them, get some of their energy out so that they'll show well on the TV. But just know that they are in a small, small kennel. Oh, I'm sorry, Bouncer's a boy. We try to get their energy out so they'll show well to you guys, but know that they're in a small kennel and they are just excited to have contact with us and be out with us and just crave that petting and the belly rubs and the ear rubs and, you know, just time to stretch their legs. So they do calm down after a little bit of time out, and sometimes it's before we get them on the show and sometimes it's not. Bouncer's tail has been docked. I would venture to say that he could be a boxer mix. He's 36 pounds. He is up to date on his vaccines and he is heartworm negative, guys. So he is going to be a perfect, perfect addition to your family. A little bit of training and a little bit of love and a whole lot of security would go a whole long way with Bouncer. He's definitely not having any aggression issues. He just wants to play. He's just a playful pup. He was a stray on Hamilton Drive on January 6th. Another one that could have gotten out on New Year's Eve, scared of the fireworks, and has really kind of grown up here now for over 2 months. So, you know, come down and give Bouncer some of your energy, and you guys go for some long walks, and maybe he could be a running partner for you. Maybe he could play frisbee with you. Maybe he is one that definitely wants to do some agility. And you know, there's an agility show at the Newnan Kennel Club is having a dog show at the fairgrounds on March 29th and 30th, and perhaps in the future, Bouncer could be one of the competitors and show everybody how well he can take commands and, you know, follow those commands and work well with his new owner. So I don't think that this weekend is the time for Mr. Bouncer, but maybe next year, come on down and get Bouncer and give him a good, good part of your family. Do you remember that there are 61 dogs and 25 cats that need your love and need a piece of your home? So come on down and meet them for yourself. Bring them into this area. it'll be kind of cool to come down and see where the green chair is and bring the angels out here and see which one really bonds with you and your family. You can bring your children, you can bring your pets, you can bring everybody to make sure it's a good match before they go home with you. Again, the adoption fees are $70 for cats, $126 for dogs, and that does include all vetting. They are located at 91 Selt Road. That is just off of Hospital Road over in Newnan. And it's a beautiful, wonderful facility, and we do appreciate greatly that they let us come down here and film this. And we appreciate New Link and our camera person, Miss Laura, for coming each week and helping us showcase these pets and reduce the number of euthanasia in this county. We have lots of events coming up. I mentioned already Newnan Kennel Club has their dog show this weekend, March 29th and 30th. It is at the fairgrounds. On Thursday, we have an event at the Wyndham in Peachtree City. It is called Foodies for Fido. And what that does is it raises money that is spent strictly on spay and neuter in Coweta County, Fayette County, and surrounding counties. And those funds are set aside for pets in our area. 100% of the donations go strictly to spay and neuter pets right here. So it will greatly impact the number of pets here, the number of pet strays around your area. So if you are unable to attend the event, please do send a donation in, or if you can attend the event, it would be wonderful. I believe there's about 15 to 20 restaurants, there's about 4 bands, dresses, come as you are, don't have to dress up, but if you want to dress up, feel free. And it is $50 for the ticket to get in. That's all of your food, all of your entertainment, and then it's $10 for a raffle ticket, and you drop that raffle ticket in whatever bucket you are interested in winning that item. I know there's some trips to get away, there's Pandora jewelry, there's Pilates classes, there's just all kinds of things. I couldn't begin to name it all if I tried. So come on out Thursday night, and for more information you can go to our website, nchsrescue.org. We also have the pet food pantry on April 5th. We also have financial assistance available for spay and neuter, and we have April 1st is come and bring your family to Partners Pizza in Summer Grove, and they will give a portion of those proceeds back to us as well. And that is, again, is for spay and neuter. And we also have an event that goes towards our foster care program out at Belk. You buy the ticket and you get to come into the early morning charity sale, and that's on May 3rd, but the tickets are available now, and if you go on our website, we'll tell you how to get them. We are winding up the Pampered Chef promotion this week, and we will be beginning an Avon promotion next week. Both of these organizations, Pampered Chef and Avon, are giving us a very nice donation towards our programs, and you just get to shop like you normally would. So get your skincare products from Avon, get your cookware products from Pampered Chef, and a portion of those proceeds come right here to our county to help us end local pet overpopulation. Thank you to New Link. Thank you to Coweta County Animal Control. Thank you to our amazing volunteers that come week in and week out and bring this show to you. Hurry back, Jeanette, we did miss you. And I did want to mention, we did show the cat basket earlier. Dogs, you have a basket too. So if you come down here and adopt from Animal Control, then your name goes in the pot to win the basket. That's it for this week. We'll see you next week, guys. Come on down. Pets are coming in every day. Pets are adopted every day. Pets are rescued every day. Come down. See what's here. See what fits in your family. And always, 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 say it with me. Spay and neuter.
Spend all your time waiting for that second chance, for a break that would make it okay. and it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distractions.